Floyd Mayweather was still fighting under the alias Pretty Boy in the year 2000. But the 22-fight unbeaten super featherweight was struggling to capture fight fans' hearts. HBO was stalling on a new deal, so the WBC champion needed to put on a show against Mexican Gregorio Vargas.
Pulling on back combat.
Excellent right hand on the inside by Mayweather. The problem for Vargas is that Mayweather is just as good an inside fighter as he is on the outside, and he'd be better.
Put him together, Jack. Put him together.
There are times when Floyd Mayweather looks almost bored in the ring, looking for ways to make it interesting for himself. There's an excellent counter left hand. And it may be at those moments when people criticize him for not being all that he can be. Excuse the takeoff and the slow. Good left hand by Mayweather. Bueno Vargas has slowed perceptibly in this bout. And you get the feeling that if Mayweather really stepped things up, he might be able to make a big difference in this fight, maybe even put a halt to it. Because while Vargas keeps coming forward, there he took a good double left hook. He does not punch him much. Again, Mayweather switches to left, and let's see if it works better this time than it did the last time. Right hook from the southpaw stance. Vargas gets a right hand in there. Winding toward the end of round six, Vargas willing, certainly coming in, ripping body shots, but Mayweather looking for the counter. Good body work, and down goes Vargas right at the end of the round from a vicious body punch.
Four, five, six,
which may give you the clue as to the way in which Mayweather might put an end to this fight by going back downstairs. Well, at the end of the round, a big surprise, while Vargas was pressing the attack, Mayweather went to the body and put him down.
Take that.
Floyd Mayweather Jr. comes out for round nine in the defense of his super featherweight championship against Goyo Vargas. Mayweather, part of a boxing family. His dad, Floyd, was a very fine professional. His career cut short when he was incarcerated and has spent years in prison. Got out several years ago and has resumed the training of Floyd Jr. His uncle Roger, a great several-time world champion. Good left right hand by Goyo Vargas. Not everything landing, but he's getting a few body shots in there. And a left hook gets in as Mayweather just covers up on the ropes. Certainly, he knows what he's doing, Mayweather, but he is taking some shots. And Vargas giving it his best. You know Mayweather's waiting to launch a counter assault here, though. Gets in by Vargas, so not all of those punches have been blocked or slipped by Mayweather. How much will this take out of Vargas, and will Mayweather be able to come back strong here in this round? And here comes Mayweather back again. But Vargas lands a left hand. Good sustained action here. Mayweather ripping rights, and Vargas coming back with a left hook. And here comes Floyd Mayweather with his combinations. Now it's probably going to be his turn. And here's Vargas with the left hook. It's toe-to-toe here in round nine, and Vargas sent back into the ropes with a crushing right hand by Mayweather. Lots of time left in this round, and now Floyd Mayweather going after Goyo Vargas. Great action here in the ninth round. Mayweather with a solid right hand. Vargas shakes it off. Another right hand by Mayweather. And the body work. Here comes Vargas off the ropes. Great action here in the ninth round with just about a half a minute left to finish Vargas off, and Vargas having none of it. There's a little swelling underneath the right eye of Floyd Mayweather Jr. So it hasn't all been roses for him here tonight. Very exciting ninth round in his super featherweight championship match. Well, if Mayweather thought he was going to take Vargas out there, he was wrong. That'll do it for a great ninth round. Mayweather going after Vargas now. Does he want to try and close the show? We'll see. Mayweather's been boxing the last couple of rounds, but now he is standing more flat-footed, and he lands a big right hand and drives Vargas back. Again, good body work by Mayweather. A more aggressive Mayweather in this round. He tries to close the show impressively in his fifth title defense. I'm sure fans looking at this, as we looked at Diego Corrales, are probably saying to themselves and taking mental notes, how would Corrales and Mayweather match up? Well, certainly Mayweather would be facing the tallest opponent he's faced. Halfway through the 12th round, Vargas trying to find a way to press the attack, and Mayweather peppering him with shots. So it looks for all the world like Floyd Mayweather will defend his title successfully for the fifth time. And the six-month layoff with the turmoil that ensued outside the ring apparently has not had a huge effect on him. He has certainly been focused this evening, performed well, if not, probably not brilliantly. Certainly wasn't as good as his performance against Carlos Arena back in September, which was really dazzling. But it's been very good. Some of the crowd not happy with him. They maybe wanted to be going after Vargas, and here's Vargas in a position where Mayweather can do it. But I think Vargas wants him to do that so he can counterpunch. Good uppercut by Mayweather. He's got all the punches. So a bout that many believe wouldn't go past the fifth or sixth round, and most of those people probably thought Mayweather would get a knockout win, has indeed just about gone the distance, and looks like it will go the full route. And while it looks like Mayweather will likely win this bout, give Goyo Vargas credit not only for toughness, but for fighting well. Just not good enough. And so the fifth defense of Floyd Mayweather's title is now over. Will it be a successful one for him? It appears to us that it would be, but Goyo Vargas may have other ideas. There's Floyd Mayweather. There's Joe Goosen with Goyo Vargas. He just lifted him over his head, signifying that they thought they won the fight. I don't know that that's the case.
Ladies and gentlemen, here at the MGM Grand, we go to the Budweiser scorecards. John Kane and Daniel Vandeville scored the bout 119 to 108. Chuck Ciampa scores at 118 to 109 for the winner and still the undefeated